Radio cabin.
Yeah, I'd like a cab at 50 Yamhill downtown, the fruit market.
Fruit stand, thank you. 23, Vanini.
Yeah, you're doing up there.
Okay, chipper. Radio cab.
Yes, I have a pickup at Pye Schmidt in Westerdahl. That's 520 Southwest Yamhill.
Room 530, right?
220.
Room 220?
Right.
Oh, I almost got that one. Right. Okay, there, thank you.
Thank you.
Radio cab. Thank you. Radio cab. 19 in Quimby. Thank you, dear.
You're welcome.
Radio.
Yeah, we got a cab about to hang out.
Radio cab. Radio cab. All right, thank you, sir.
Radio cab.
Yeah, Dad's in St. John's, please.
Dad's? Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you.
Yeah, could I have one at 19665?
19665.
Southwest.
Southwest.
Rock Road.
Ready cab.
Yeah, how long would it take you to get a cab over to the state motel? I wanted to make the liquor store for it.
The what motel?
The state motel is 2020 Northeast 82.
2020 Northeast 82?
Yeah.
What's your room number? Oh, I think I can get you on there in probably about 15 minutes or so.
Okay.
Uh-huh. Right. Ready cab.
Do you have a cab available? Or you'd be real busy?
What area, ma'am?
It's North Portland. Well, I've called the Broadway, and they're busy, and I didn't know whether to call radio or not.
What address?
Well, they were too busy.
Okay, what's your address?
6626 North Greenwich.
6626 North Greenwich?
Uh-huh.
Oh, I think I can get you on there in probably about 15 minutes.
Very fine.
Did you cancel them out?
Yes, I will, right now.
Okay, thank you. Ready, cab? Ready, cab?
My cab on the way to Duncan's?
I'm sure it is, dear.
You sure it is?
Uh-huh.
Okay, thanks.
Well, I'll put a call back on it, just in case. Right. But I don't see the order hanging.
Okay.
Ready, cab?
Hannah's Tavern.
Hannah's, thank you. 40? Northwest 20 and Hawk. Okay, thank you. Ready, cab?
Yeah, could you send a cab to the Cheerful Tortoise, please?
Cheerful Tortoise?
Right.
Okay, sir, thank you.
Mm-hmm. Bye-bye.
Ready, cab?
Hey, this is University Hospital South. Have you received a call for a cab on Robinson?
No, I don't believe so.
Yeah. Okay, can I place that order?
Robinson?
Yeah, cash fare up at the ninth floor.
Okay,
thank you.
Bye-bye. Ready,
cab? Yeah, it's Easy Aircrafters.
Yes, sir.
We got a package down at Cole and Weber, taped to the door. 220 Southwest Morrison.
Okay, and it's taped to door.
Taped to the door. Bring it up to Paul O'Geezy, 2115 Northwest 20th.
2115 Northwest 20. Okay, sir.
That's the plan.
That's the plan. We'll deliver it.
All righty.
Yeah, quite well. Ready, cab?
Yeah, is that cab on the way to Safeway?
Which one, ma'am? Which Safeway?
On Division. I called 30 minutes ago, and I'm sitting.
Yeah, cab one. It's across street there, ma'am.
Burnside and Division. Well, how much longer will he be?
Should be any minute now, ma'am.
Okay, is he going to stop at Safeway right in front of the door?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you.
Uh-huh.
Bye.
Ready, cab?
Yeah, up at Specs Chicken on 21st and Burnside.
Very interesting working here because, well, the one guy was upset and threatened to come over the counter and punch my face in. Another guy was extremely excited and happy and grabbed me by the shoulders and started to pull me through my own little window, which is only about that big, and I made it almost all the way through. We get sweet little old people calling for script, and one little lady calls and never calls less than five times, but we always get it to her. Oh, let's see. The charges get lost. That's always fun to try and find. Some of the things we get calls on for lost and found. One guy lost his upper plate, and it had his name in the top somewhere. And I'm going, who's going to turn in upper plates? Nobody wants to touch those.
Well, the most interesting thing about driving a cab or in the cab business is non-repetitious. It's changing. There's a certain amount of repetition to each day, but each day there's something different, something new.
You're running into people that are nice people, weirdos, freaks, and they're all different combination of everything, and you get to look at everything there is in the world for at least 8 or 10 hours a night.
It's not like punching a clock and doing routine work or assembly line work. Each and every cab driver could write a book and each one would be different. interesting also.
I'm on the move all the time. It's better than standing in a shop someplace and waiting for something to come to you and nothing to do. This way I keep busy and there's just a lot of fun all the way around. It's enjoyable.
Suppose that in the long run I wouldn't want to drive cab for the rest of my life, but in the short term, say 2 to 3 years, I think I would enjoy driving cab and probably would remain doing so for, I'd say, 2 to 3 years, which time I'm sure I'd be ready for a change.
I think the thing I like best about driving cab is the indiscrimination of it. You never know who you're going to pick up. Could be good or could be bad, but it's going to be someone you'll deal with on an interpersonal level if you choose to. It allows you the freedom to explore human behavior at its basic level, which for me as an actor is like doing my homework.
Drives days. We used to take a lady up to Seattle, Washington to put flowers on her husband's grave and turn around and come back. And she did that quite a few times.
I remember when I picked up my first fare out in North Portland, and I usually wouldn't have marked in at all, but I did, and the dispatcher said, pick up such and such a tavern, and so with some hesitation I pulled up to in front of the bar and went in and said radio cab, and a man who was extremely intoxicated comes out and gets in the cab, stares at me and says, you're a woman, I can't believe it. And I said, where do you want to go? And he says, I can't believe you're a woman. And he kept repeating this time after time, and I was getting upset, and you know, time is money. And so I said, if you're not going to tell me where you want to go, then get out of the cab. And he said, I refuse to, at which point I said, I'll make you get out. And I whipped out of the car and I opened his door and I jerked him by the arm, and because he was so inebriated, I pulled him out onto the sidewalk, shut the door and drove away and left him sitting on a sidewalk.
Got it written down on a piece of paper here. Oh, there it is. 2017 Northeast Weidler, and please hurry. I'm just incredibly late. Oh, my God. Make it. $1 minimum? What's that all about? It wasn't that much the last time I took a cab. I can't tell you what a horrible day it's been for me. You know, I had to take my dog to the vet, and it was just awful. And the car broke down. That's why I'm taking the cab in the first place. I don't usually take taxi cab.
Yeah.
I'm really sorry to keep bugging you, but don't you think you could go just a little bit faster?
Yes, ma'am.
This is just really bad.
I try to take the best way I know, ma'am.
I wonder if sometimes if cab drivers just go the wrong way just so they can make more money. I swear to God. I think you're going the wrong way.
Ma'am, I might have made a wrong turn.
It's just not my day. Well, please hurry. This is just, it's getting beyond belief.
I think I made a mistake, ma'am.
And it's going to cost me more money, too, isn't it?
Well, at least we have a turnaround here.
Just get me there. That's all I care about.
Would you please sit back, please?
No, I'm not going to sit back. I want to pay attention. You went the wrong way once.
Hey, would it help? Would it make
you
any happier if I shut the meter off?
Well, no, that would be ridiculous. Well, I don't know. Just get me there.
Well, there's a challenge in the cab business. It's unlimited how much you can earn. I mean, you go on the street, and if you're a good hustler, you can make an extra buck, and you try to build up a clientele for yourself. I had a lot of personals when I drove cab, and that made my business.